The island has everything in it that the suitcase in Pulp Fiction had in it. You know what I'm saying? Nothing. A fucking gold light. That's all it had in it. Like, there's nothing going on there. And you're supposed to care about these characters, but then they try to make you care about characters from hundreds of years ago for no reason.
Yeah, from... Oh, okay, you know what I found out? That Jacob and all that stuff happened, like, when they were younger. That was, like, Rome era.
Yeah.
Like, ancient Rome.
Definitely.
Super way...
Yeah, just look at the boats and shit they're on. Yeah. Even, like, Richard was hella back there, so you know if Jacob was there way before him, that fucking shit had to be way... Which brings me to my next point. Is that lady the smoke monster, their mom? Because she fucking ripped up an entire village and lit it on fire, and she's not like she had grenades.
Yeah, I'm thinking she was... Like, she was the balance. Like, she was
both good and evil.
She was good and evil. Because she was the only one there. She didn't have a smoke monster. She was...
She hella killed that lady.
Yeah, she fucking
got... Rock bludgeoning and shit. That was... The whole thing is, like, Jacob's thing is, like, oh, I don't want to interfere with these people's lives. It's like, well, then why did you make them come to the island?
Yeah, that's all we're around touching.
It doesn't make any sense.
Crazy.
Oh, I just wanted to take over with my job and stuff. It's like, but, you know, really? The job wasn't that important, apparently.
If he hadn't gone around bringing everybody to the island, he would still be alive.
Well, that's another thing, too. Why did he want to not do it anymore?
Because
he wouldn't have died unless he let himself die. Like, he should have been able to protect the island forever.
Yeah.
So, that's another fucking plot hole. Jake was just bored of it.
Yeah, he had been just bored of it. Because the only reason he died was because all those people came to the island and the smoke monster was able to inhabit Locke's body. And convince Ben to stab him.
Stab him, right. And then at that point, Jacob still almost stopped him. He's like, you don't have to do this, but really, he knew he was going to do it. Yeah, so basically, Jacob's character doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, if nobody was there in the first place, Jacob wouldn't have had to
worry about it.
Yeah.
He wouldn't have had to have protected it from anything. Okay. And that guy wouldn't have been able to get off the island either, because there wouldn't have been anyone there to kill Jacob to get him off the island. And Yada got a fucking Yada.
It would have been the same.
Yeah, they would have just hung out on the island together. And there would be no show.
We just have a show about hanging out on an island with two fucking dudes.
Yeah, right, exactly.
One wears black, one wears white.
It's like, I don't understand how Lost is supposed to be better than The Sopranos and stuff like that. Like, people compare it to Deadwood. And it's like, it's not. It's not that bad. It's not cable TV, which makes a big difference. Because commercials alone suck.
Yeah.
And not even that, but like, ooh, kissing is a sex scene, you know what I mean? Like, that kind of stuff. Like, that's not. Isn't Kate kinda has her clothes are a little half off, like, ooh,
yeah,
that's hot, like, ooh. And that's another thing, people who watch the show because Kate's hot, they get a fucking clue, dude. If you watch anything because a girl's hot, like, there's hot girls everywhere.
Yeah,
and hot girls and good shit. Hot girls and shitty stuff. Like, if you're watching something just because a girl's hot, get laid, bro. That's all I have to say about that.
But
Kate was terrible, her character was terrible, her acting was terrible. The fact that she just did the same thing over and over was terrible. I guess it made sense that she followed Jack and killed Locke, because she followed Jack everywhere, blah, blah, blah. She should have followed him to his death, too, then.
Yeah, she should have. She just went
off the island and probably fucked Sawyer for 10 years, and then they went to the flesh side of it together. Whatever. Or, you know what it was? He probably helped raise Sawyer's baby and fucking Claire's baby with Kate. Wait, Claire was on the plane, too, right?
Yeah.
She just Claire gets
fucked. Yeah.
That makes sense. That's the one I forgot. She lives fucking.
Yeah, they know like 15 minutes earlier in the episode, she's like, I can't go back, I'm fucking nuts.
She just walks off and
she's like, oh, wait, no, it's cool.
Kate told me I had to go, I guess I'll go.
Okay.
Yeah, because Kate's the best. So apparently, Kate was Jacob.
Yeah.
That's what I feel.
That happened, man.
You want to talk about who was really running the show. Even at the end on the Flash Sideways, she was telling Jack what to do.
Yep.
Kate just did everything.
See, I thought if they were going to continue the whole island thing, I figured Desmond was going to be the new Jacob.
Yeah.
Because he was going around.
It was between Jack Hurley and Jacob and Desmond for me, and then it ended up being Jack and Hurley, which was funny. And I thought, man, I like that Ben and Hurley. Like, I want to see that so bad. Like, Ben and Hurley just hanging out on an island together, doing their own thing. Like, that's gotta be funny.
Let's go catch some fish.
Even that, like, remember when John Locke and Ben were trying to find Jacob's cabin, and they had to bring Hurley with them, and they made Hurley come and shit.
Yeah, Hurley was going on the new, but he didn't really know.
Yeah, he's seen the cabin, but it's like you're not supposed to see the cabin unless you're badass. And, like, so ever since then, I guess you could say that Hurley was on that route. But they basically... And that's another thing. How did Jacob, or not Jacob, but how did Hurley and Ben die on the island?
They never touched on anything about that. Because they're all still...
Because there's no answers. That's why they don't touch on it. Because they have nothing to say.
No answers.
Because they just bullshitted their way through fucking 6 seasons of our lives, and that's that. Man, I'm not buying the DVDs, I don't think. If someone came up to you right now and was like, would you recommend Lost to me? What would you say?
I would say watch the first season.
And stop?
Stop. Give it a serious think. A serious think. And then if you feel that maybe you want to watch more people stuck on a fucking island.
Right, but that's, I mean, well, that too, but like if that was what it was about, that'd be fine. But like the first season, you watch that, and then when you watch the sixth season, it's got nothing to do with the first season. It's got nothing to do with it. You know what I'm saying? Like that's the thing. Like, the first season was good. Second season was good. The third season was fine. The fourth season got a little stupid. Fifth season got way stupid, and the sixth season was garbage.
I would say watch first, third, and fifth seasons, and then second, fourth, and sixth, just watch recaps or read about
them. Yeah, because the second one does drag on a little bit when you got all the Michael Waltz stuff going on.
Because that's all it is. It's Michael and his
kid. I gotta get my son.
I gotta help my kid.
I'm gonna call you Jack. Get in the cage, dude.
Like, exactly. Killing people.
Killing Alicia and fucking Libby.
And Libby, dude.
Cynthia Waltrip. The girl from Titus. Titus was better than Lost. Real talk.
At least it was sick funny.
Yeah, exactly. At least at the end of it, I wasn't like, man, I wasted a lot of time watching this show.
Yeah. Ugh. Lost wasted pretty much, well, I didn't watch every season, so no, yeah. Technically it wasted like 5 years of my life.
Well, yeah, you didn't watch them all from the start. You know what I mean? But I didn't either. I didn't get into it until like a little into the second season.
Yeah.
And then I went back and stuff. But, you know, the second season brought me in because of all the scientific aspects of it, like the whole electromagnetic fucking anomalies and the Dharma Initiative and things like that. And then by the end of it, like, they got to live in the Dharma Initiative, which was kind of cool, but the whole thing was the Dharma Initiative was pointless.
So. Yeah, because they were all, because of them, so.
They had cool jumpsuits, I guess. But,
cool suit, like, little symbols
of ashes, little octagons or whatever the fuck. But, man, I was not impressed at all with Lost. Now that I think about it, it's just like.
Yeah, now I'm talking about it.
Every single thing you can like talk about like that would have been good. By the time you break it down, the story doesn't just
make sense.
Yeah, it's like even the thing with like Penny going to pick up the wine at the monk's thing, and then meeting Desmond. Like Eloise knew that was gonna happen,
she knew.
And she probably told Widmore to send Penny to go pick up that wine on that day. Da 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 da. And that's cool to think about in a way, but at the same time, if it means that the story just ends stupidly like that, what's the point of all the cool stuff? You know.
They just had to put it in.
Because the show was called Jack.
Yep.
That's all it was. Desmond
Jack on Island.
Yeah. Jack on Island. Yeah. Jack's Eye. Because that's what I was telling somebody the other day. I was like, J.J. Abrams not only didn't care about the story at all, he probably pitched it like, alright, it's going to open on a dude on an island, his eye. And then the last thing ever will be his eye closing. Whatever happens in between, sorry. Just give it to that fuck, one of these guys to write.
Yep.
And they'll figure it out.
Give it to this dude with the glasses. Yeah. They both have.
Yeah, and then get the ball guy to get his fucking kosher meals and stuff. It's just ridiculous. Ridiculous. J.J. Abrams, you fuck.
Yeah, come on, bro.
Star Trek was cooler than Lost. That's sad. The Star Trek movie, not the show, obviously. But yeah, fucking terrible, man. Worst fucking 6 seasons ever. Like, I mean, Deadwood didn't even get to end. Carnival didn't get to end. But Lost got to end, and it was garbage.
That's disgusting, man.
I remember season 3 when they were like, okay, the seasons aren't going to be 20 episodes anymore, and we're going to have a plan, we're going to build towards that plan, da 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 da. And like, that was the plan.
That was for one season.
That was the plan? That wasn't the plan. There's no way the Smoke Monster plan was the plan.
Terry O'Quinn didn't even know he was playing the Smoke Monster in the 6th season.
Yeah, that's what he said until the very end. That's because the writers didn't fucking know.
Because they said, like, oh.
So bad.
Jesus.
So bad. You can't think ahead a little bit, just a little bit? For your peeps? I guess not.
But that's not.
Hit that harmonica. I'm sick of talking about this shit.